It's mu.
Mu.
Yeah.
Mu.
Yeah.
Let's be real. Talking about music is great, but sometimes you just want to ask really personal questions. With this in mind, we asked Karen Marie Orsted, aka Mu, on a date. The perfect guise under which to be nosy. The Danish singer cut her teeth in a teen punk duo, writing feminist songs like Pussy in Your Face. But it was when she went solo that she really came into her own. Her 2014 debut, No Mythologies to Follow, a slew of singles, and an ongoing partnership with Major Lazer, including their global hit Lean On, truly cemented the 29-year-old's reputation for penning perfect hooks. Most recently, she released new EP When I Was Young, so we scooped her up for a hot date.
So are you ready for our date?
Yes, I'm super ready.
I decided to take you to Trash and Vaudeville because it's an East Village punk mainstay. Should we go in and see?
Very good choice. Yeah, that's so nice. I can't believe anyone ever took me here.
Never took you here.
No, yeah, no, I never, yeah. Oh, sorry. Sorry for the danglish. When you're gorgeous, you know
you might not always feel like it, but you are. Is style important for you when you're looking at a potential partner?
I actually like when they just wear like whatever, like, and they like they're in their own world doing their thing. They don't care about, you know, like.
Yeah, there's something kind of unappealing about a person who looks like they spent too much time on like putting things together.
Exactly. And you're worth it. I assure you, I will dye my hair in crazy colors.
Given that you came from like a punk activist scene, is it still important for you to be saying something in your music today?
It's important for me to be honest in my music and to talk and sing and write about some things that I honestly care about and feel. In these days, I feel like in pop music and also in commercial, kind of more commercial situations. Mm. Sorry again for the Danglish English thing.
I love your Danglish.
I feel like it's getting more and more, like in a way, it's more hip to talk about, like feminism, for instance. Sometimes if something gets too commercial, it takes away some of the power of it.
Right.
At the same time.
Well, how many tattoos do you have?
I think I have like 11 or 12.
Oh, wow.
To get
what
that
was
done.
The first tattoo that you got and how old were you?
It was this one, the Moomin. Yeah.
I love Moomin.
Me too. Like, I'm obsessed.
Are you?
Like, I'm fucking crazy.
Can you remember the first time you fell in love?
Yeah. I was 14 or something.
Yeah.
It was so blown up. I remember I couldn't control the feelings. It was like too powerful.
But
it was
that's just what like, it's like to be a teenager.
You know, like 14, I never really kissed a boy for real before. And you know, I thought he was so handsome and he was so cool. And I was just like so young and confused and like insecure. Like I was a mess, you know? And I just remember freaking the fuck out about being with this fucking incredible guy.
How long did it last?
3 weeks. And he was like not nice to me at all.
I mean, how hard is it to be able to maintain a relationship given the fact that you're like traveling all the time, you're in all these different time zones, like your career is kind of like your first love, I suppose.
Yeah, it is really fucking hard to find someone who's like okay with you traveling all the time, and when you come home you're moody and feeling weird and jet lagged and everything's like ah.
Yeah.
So you just basically you gotta find one that's just super balanced and stable, I guess.
Are you a jealous person?
Only if I have a reason.
Okay,
you know?
Yeah.
And or like in the beginning of a relationship, again, when you're super in love and then you find out they had like this super fucking hot model ex-girlfriend, I'll be like,
tough.
Fuck!
That is tough.
You know, fuck! And then I'll get over it. Yeah. I'll get over it, for
but
sure.
But it's hard in this day and age because it's like you can then just Google all their super hot ex-girlfriends.
Oh, it sucks. That's why I don't really want to know.
Yeah.
At the same time, you totally want to know. You want to know everything.
But women want to know everything.
Yes.
And guys don't want to know anything.
No, I get that. And I kind of want to be more like a guy with those things. I mean, again, like some women are like that as well,
but
I want to be more like whatever, like who cares? Like,
so I'm going to take you to my favorite East Village dive bar.
Name as well.
Here's to our day.
Day drinking. Yeah, it's here's to our day.
And day drinking. So, top five deal breakers.
Okay. Arrogance for sure.
Okay.
They want to change me. They're like, why don't you put like on high heels? Or like, why don't you do a little bit? Or like, maybe you should work out. I mean, you know, like if people are like too like trying to fix me, it's like, well, don't bother. I mean, if they're abusive, that can be a problem in the long run, you know.
Abusive is a little bit of a deal breaker. Yeah, I will give you that.
This is a weird one, maybe, but like, if I feel like they're only interested in me because like I'm a little bit famous, then mm-hmm. like that's definitely no. He has to be able to live with a cat.
Oh, see, yes. That was going to be one of my questions: dog or cat person? You're a cat person.
I'm
clearly. Cat.
I love. I mean, I'm a super animal freak lover, you know. But cats are my. What do you call it? Like spirit animal?
Yeah, they're your spirit. Why?
I don't know. I really don't know. Maybe just because I grew up with cats. I'm okay. Like, I dream about cats all the time. Like, and I think about cats all the time. Like, seriously.
Really?
Yeah, it's so weird. Like, I mean it.
You've worked extensively with Diplo songwriting for years.
Sometimes if I work on something, I'll get lost. And he's very good at just cutting through in a way, being like, this is cool, this works, this doesn't work, get, you know, which is an amazing, like, gift to have. You know, I've been a fan of those guys for so many years, so I'm also just like, it's a kind of a curse for me, like every beat they play, I'll be like, oh my god, this is so good, we had to write on this one, like, oh my god, this is so good, like, so it's a treat.
Yeah, because yeah. I found it interesting that you, like, they had a bunch of beats or songs and then you wrote top lines for them, and then, but then sometimes those songs went to other artists.
Yeah, like a little bit like the, on that album where Lean On is on, Peace Is The Mission, the song with Ariana Grande, the All My Love. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I wrote that one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And were you like, damn it, it went to Grande.
The songs that you love, you always want to sing.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I'm super realistic about that also, that like, of course, I mean, if Ariana want to sing it, like, great, awesome, fucking great.
Go for it. What music do you have coming out soon?
I am going to put out an EP pretty soon, which I'm super excited about. The theme is going to be about, like, you know, the whole like collective escape, you know, like that I feel I'm a part of and that everybody's a part of, like refusing to grow up and like have responsibility and like just kind of like, no, everything's fine, it's gonna be fine, like, oh
yeah,
you know what I mean.
And, yeah, and we're all suffering a little bit from Peter Pan syndrome.
I was just about to say that's the theme, like the whole Peter panning thing, like so funny you say that, exactly that. I think the most personal one is called Runaway.
Okay.
Yeah.
And that is as explanatory as the title.
It's more like a coming of age song, actually. It's that thing about like how through life some people tell you that this is not right, like this is not the right way to do things, like mm-hmm. you can't be like this. And then about just accepting who you are and realizing that fuck you, you were never right.
Like, yeah.
You know.
How do you think our date went?
It's like the perfect date.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes. Nailed it.
Yeah, totally did.
Okay, great.
We'll go on a date with you anytime.
Yay! Cheers to that.
Yeah. Cheers. Every time I say my name in Danish, I get like a funny face. Mø. You know, like, mø. Because I'm trying to convince this person how to say it. Oh.
Is someone raking the concrete?